Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatic channel. Today, I'm very excited to share with everyone the latest collab between C.R.K.T. and Jesper Voxnaes. Undoubtedly a fan favorite, and per the previous versions, the design has created a cult following. Here we have the newly redesigned Pilar 3. And first, I want to cover the specs of the new Pilar, and then take a peek inside and see what's going on, and finish up by assessing some of the changes in addition to my personal thoughts. Starting with a handle length of 4 1/4 inches, the Pilar sports a full G10 scale on the show side, and the lock side is stainless steel, following suit with its predecessor, the Pilar Large. The hardware remains T8 for the pivot and T6 hex for the body and clip screws. The Pilar 3 is utilizing a frame locking system and has a handle thickness of 0.42 inch. Returning to its original roots, the 3's only means of deployment is its signature pill-shaped thumb hole. The new blade is also the largest, coming in at 3 inches in length, thus holding the crown and longest cutting edge at 2 3/4 inch. Classified as a spear point with a flat grind and a nice size forward finger choil, the blade's new shape, ergos, and blade thickness of 150 thousandths of an inch appear more functional in everyday EDC tasks. This unit's blade steel is actually comprised from D2, which is stamped on the blade following the model number. Another sign this is the D2 variant is the awesome stone wash finish by CRKT, and not only on the blade, but the lock side, in addition to the brass backspacer and pocket clip. The Pilar 3 is running on the IBKS bearings, making the action buttery smooth, and the blade centering is spot on right out of the box. So let's unscrew the hardware and have a close look at the internals. Side note, CRKT did use blue Loctite on the body screws running through the backspacer, so you must have 2 T6 hex bits and 2 bit drivers. Use lots of pressure and move slowly as to not strip the hardware. And at this point, I will make a quick mention of this new frame screw that appears in front of the pocket clip on the lock bar, which we will see more of very shortly. Moving along to the front end of the handles, although the same remains with Loctite and the pivot screw, the female side is captured with a D-shape, coupled with added torque by the T8, makes removing the pivot less tedious of a task. As we open her up, you can clearly see the ball bearings, which are steel and caged by a nylon base washer. There is only one removable washer in the pivot that sits adjacent to the G10 show side, while the steel lock side has a milled race for the bearings to run in. If you take a look into the midsection of the lock bar, you will notice the bottom side of the screw I spoke on earlier that anchors the over travel stop tab. There is no internal milling, but there is a slight texturing in the lock release area, as well as relief on the G10 side. The Pilar spacer on the D2 variant is brass with a stone wash finish, and the lanyard area protrudes out from the rear of the handle. The pocket clip is now a fold-over deep carry, with the mount side of the clip and the screws both recessed. After reassembly, I'll give the last of my specs on this build. Coming in at an overall length of 7 1/4 inches and a total weight of 3 0.82 ounce, the D2 P3 is the largest Pilar in both categories. And on the opposite side of the spectrum, the P3 is also the thinnest out of the set. This is how, in my opinion, the new design was able to lengthen the entire build, but only move the scales in gaining a mere 0.24 ounce, or 6.8 grams. As for some of the significant design changes, the blade steel, shape, and finish, although there were some special runs and higher steels on both the original and Pilar Large, being offered right out of the gate in different variants by CRKT is a first for the design. The blade shape actually has the same cutting edge shape, a continuous belly with a very subtle rise in the curve. The spine side seems to have been modded the most, with a lot less of an aggressive drop on the swedge, and by it being elongated, this gives it more of a spear point shape. The factory direct stone wash is a very nice touch, while the previous iterations sported a satin finish over a sheep's foot shape. The pocket clip is definitely a major upgrade from the shorter clip used on the last two Pilars. The P3 has done away with the design's tip-down pocket clip position. The overall profile and the closed position is more streamlined and definitely a lot less to deal with and maneuver around while in pocket. The ergos feel just a hairline more dialed in, as well as more nimble and efficient when performing cutting motions and tasks. The use of the over-travel stop and D2 steel on the first run speaks to CRKT hearing some of its people and quickly responding with updates and upgrades. The best change, in my personal opinion, as a hardcore fidgeter, is the action provided by those tiny cage bearings, which is totally unreal. lightning fast on the deploy, and the retraction is ultra smooth. The P3's blade can be deployed with every finger and in many different ways. The Pilar Large does have a finger tab, but with it running nylon washers, the action is lackluster in comparison. If you compare the Pilar Large and Pilar 3's thumb hole, the 3's is noticeably bigger, aiding in the use of deployment when wearing gloves. In conclusion, I must say this is definitely the king of Pilar designs. With a sleek profile, thin frame, and slicey blade geometry, awesome ergos, and a handle that my entire hand can grip comfortably without having to use the choil area. And again, it's that amazing action on a $50 knife that solidifies the pocket time this folder will be receiving by me. I must tip my hat to maker Jesper Voxnaes, the creator of this design, and C.R.K.T. for such a long, successful run with the Pilar. And I'm proud to say I own all three iterations in the set. Which Pilar do you believe to be the best and why? Also, which blade shape are you more fond of, the original or the latest? Leave a comment down below with your take on both questions. And please subscribe to the channel for all new content. Share, like, and thanks for tuning in. Signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.